Welcome pilots, this will be a streamlined video on how to squeeze the most performance out of your Windows PC while playing the MechaBREAK beta playtest. We'll be focusing on Nvidia-based GPU systems, but those with AMD or Intel cards can follow along, as some of these settings will apply to your system as well. This video will not be covering basic Windows settings or optimizations. Please follow another video if you're interested in those tweaks. I will link one in the description. If you have any further questions, please drop them in the comments or swing by twitch.tv kills in a night where you can ask me any number of questions you might have. All right, currently MechaBREAK does not have an in-game FPS counter, so we're going to have to enable one outside of the game. You can use Steam, you can use GeForce Experience, you can use RevaTuner, AMD, any one of those things that you're used to. But for the simplest solution, I'm going to show you how to enable the FPS counter within Steam. So you're going to open up Steam, you're going to head to Steam, top left, and you're going to navigate to Settings. You're going to go to In-Game and enable the Steam overlay while in-game. Enable that on. I have this off. If you don't need any of the Steam overlay stuff during gameplay, I recommend turning this off. But for the purposes of this video, we're going to turn this on so we can enable the FPS counter. Here we go, in-game FPS counter. We're going to put this in the top right. That's where I like it. And why not high FPS contrast color? Why not turn that on? There is no apply settings. You just have to exit out and we're good to go. The next step for those of you running on an Nvidia based graphics card, you're going to right click on the desktop, hit Nvidia control panel. Once that's open, you're going to navigate to 3D settings and adjust image settings with preview. You're going to make sure use the advanced 3D image settings option is toggled and you're going to press apply. Next, you'll head down to the manage 3D settings tab. We're not going to do anything in the global settings tab. We're going to head over to program settings. And here we're going to add MechaBREAK. Under recently used, MechaBREAK shows up for me. If it doesn't show up for you in the top here, you can scroll down to try to find MechaBREAK. If you don't see it, you can browse to find it. Hit the browse button here. Now I have my Steam games installed on my D drive. You might have it on your C drive. So wherever you have your Steam games installed, that's where you're going to navigate to. You're going to hit either program files or some people have Steam games in program x86. Open up that, head to Steam, Steam apps, common, scroll down to MechaBREAK playtest. And here's the application. You're going to just double click on that and it will add it to the program queues. Now we're only going to touch on a few settings. We're going to scroll down to low latency mode. I'm going to turn this on. For those of you with G-Sync compatible displays, you can play around with the ultra setting. I find that it adds a little bit more latency than I'd like. So for me, the best bet is on, but play around, try ultra, it might work for you. What this does is going to limit the number of frames your CPU can write in advance of your GPU handling them. So with it on, it's going to limit it to basically one frame in addition to the frame that's being currently written by your GPU. This is going to prevent it from trying to write up to three frames, which can really impact the latency of your system. So definitely turn this on. Max frame rate, we'll touch on this later, but we're going to scroll down. Power management mode, I've turned this on. Perform maximum performance, I find this is the best option for MechaBREAK. Preferred refresh rate for your current monitor, the monitor that you are using to game on, I always put this at highest available. Next, the crucial step, vertical sync. We're going to force this off at the driver level. We're going to make sure no matter what the game does, that VSync is not on. With those settings enabled, we're going to press apply. Your screen may flicker. Okay. Just double check, we got low latency mode on, prefer maximum performance, highest available refresh rate, and VSync is off. We're good to go. You can safely exit out of Nvidia control panel. Next, we're going to load up the game just like normal. All right, once we're safely in the hangar, we're going to take note of our FPS. We're hitting 5960, which is a little unusual. Why are we only getting up to 60 frames? What is happening here? Well, let's hit the escape key here. Let's go to settings and under the display settings, general, I'm going to scroll down and notice that vertical sync by default is off. Generally, it's what you want, but let's try turning it on. Press apply. All right, you notice that our frames have now jumped up. So with the FPS unlocked, we're going to head over to the graphics setting. Most of these settings are going to align with the quality of the PC that you have. If you have a potato PC, a lot of these are going to be low or off. If you have a medium PC, they're going to be on medium to high. If you have an ultra high-end PC, You can have a lot of these on high as well as some on ultra. Rendering quality, high is about as high as I would want to have it, even if I had an ultra system. I think the performance hit is a little bit too much going up to ultra, but that's up to you. A lot of these settings will be personal preference, but somewhat tied to the quality of your PC. Texture, again, I'm going high, I'm not going ultra. Depth of field, this is a personal preference thing. I usually have this off in most games. Some people like it on. It's a little bit of a hit, so I usually turn it off. Motion blur, there is already a lot of motion blur in this game with motion blur off, so I'm not sure what's going on there. It could be like an artistic choice that the devs have made to make the game feel more like an anime. But for now, I've turned off motion blur. We'll see, maybe they implement a different strategy once the game releases. Interface soft lighting, this is about like your UI, your HUD. It adds a little bit of immersion, a little bit of depth to it, not much of an impact, so I have this on. Global illumination, this is going to be one of your bigger hits. If you have an ultra high-end PC, you can definitely have this on high. For most, I recommend low. You still have some depth in the lighting, but those on potato PCs might find the best results by having this disabled. Game will be a little flat, but still good. Still looks good with disabled, but I would definitely try to have this on low if you can. Screen space occlusion. I would only consider turning this on if you have an ultra high-end PC. It just doesn't do much. The game moves much too fast for those little nuances to be noticed, in my opinion. Again, a lot of this is personal preference, but I have screen space ambient occlusion off. Screen space reflection is only available if you've chosen the rendering quality ultra. So you have that on now. For those of you with the super high-end PCs, you might play around with turning this on. It does look pretty cool. You have some pretty cool reflections and flat surfaces and water. But for me, don't really need that. I'm turning that off. I'm saving some of my performance. Volumetric fog, again, I have this off. It kind of looks cool. Adds a little bit of immersion. But for performance-wise, I'm going to opt to have this off. Scene interactions on. Not much of a performance hit with these with this setting, so I've chosen to have mine on. Weather is a little bit of an impact here. I like to have mine on high. I feel that it does provide some more depth, some more immersion in the game, but it comes at a cost. So if you're trying to squeeze the most out of your PC, you definitely want to have this on low or off. These next four settings are going to align almost one for one with your PC quality. These settings are virtual geometry precision, terrain grid precision, terrain rendering details, and vegetation precision. If you have an ultra high-end PC, you can feel free to set these to high or ultra. If you have a medium PC, you want to have them a medium or high. And if you have a potato PC, I would turn most of these to low. Next up is special effects. I prefer to have this setting on as high as it can go if it doesn't have a drastic impact on performance. It definitely has a impact, so you want to pay attention to that. Most people will be happy with medium. If you have an ultra high-end PC, I would go with high or ultra. All right, next up is super resolution. This is a setting that allows your GPU to render the game at a lower resolution and then upscale it to your monitor's resolution. So it saves in performance, but it comes at a cost of fidelity. If you have an Nvidia card, you're going to want to try turning on Nvidia Deep Learning Super Sampling. If you have an AMD card, you're going to want to try turning on AMD Fidelity Super Resolution. They basically do the same thing. Like I said, they render the game at a lower resolution and then upscale it later on the GPU level. In terms of quality, I think the default's automatic. That's going to have the system choose for you. I don't recommend that. Sometimes it chooses a little bit higher than you would want. For the most part, I would align this with your PC's quality. Again, if you have a potato PC, definitely put this on performance. Medium to high PC, balance is the best bet. Ultra quality PC, ultra high-end PC, you're going to want to go with quality. And just avoid the deep learning for now. If you choose not to do super resolution, you're going to have an option for anti-aliasing quality. You're going to want to have this on medium or high. Not much of an impact with anti-aliasing with today's systems. But play around with that. You may like it off. But for now, I'm turning on NVIDIA Deep Learning Super Sampling with a super resolution quality of balanced. If you have a 40 series GPU card, you may have frame interpolation available. I believe that's what it requires. The graphics card is going to write frames in between the frames the CPU writes. So it's essentially doubling your frame rate, but it comes at a cost. It definitely has an impact in system latency, and it's not perfect. There are some artifacts. It's basically the GPU is guessing on what that frame would look like, but it's up to you. You can turn it on and the game might feel smoother to you, or it might feel a little bit laggy to you. But personal preference, if you have a 40 series, it's worth giving a shot, turning it on to see what the results are. So after you've made these choices, these changes, make sure you press apply and you can return, exit out. Next up would be to load in to a game. I'm just gonna load into training now. For the purposes of this video, I've jumped into a training session. I recommend that you jump into some multiplayer and just take note, keep track of what your FPS is. What's the average FPS you're getting? Is it 160s? Is it in the 180s? Is it above the 200s? Just to keep track of that. Generally, when I'm in multiplayer, I'm getting about 140, 138 on average. Sometimes it dips down a little bit lower, sometimes a little bit higher. What we're going to do is we're going to take that number and we're going to jump back into the NVIDIA control panel and we're going to apply a frame rate cap to the game. All right, once again on the desktop, you're going to right click NVIDIA control panel, navigate to the Manage 3D Settings. Hit the Program Settings tab, make sure you're in MechaBREAK. Right here, you can see the long one, MechaBREAK Playtest. You're gonna scroll down until we find Max Frame Rate. I'm gonna turn this on and we're gonna set it. I recommend setting it to about 25% higher than the frame rate you're comfortably getting. So for me, that's about 165. For instance, if you're getting 160 FPS normally, you might want to set that to, you know, 192 or 200. You're going to press OK and apply. What this is going to do is limit the total number of frames your system is allowed to write. Without a cap on it, it's going to try to write as many frames as possible, up to like 300. As soon as you put a cap on it, it no longer tries to do that, which frees up some of the resources. It makes it, you know, gives it a little bit more breathing room. Perhaps some less stutters, perhaps some smoothness. So definitely consider capping your frames. I've set mine at 165, like I said, but this is the number you can play around with. You can raise it, you can lower it, but I definitely recommend, at least for this playtest, setting your max frame rate for MechaBREAK. That's going to do it. Hopefully this video will help you achieve some smoother frame rates, some unlocked frame rates, less stutters, and overall better gaming experience whilst playing the MechaBREAK playtest. If you have any questions or comments, or you want to share your results, please drop those in the comments below. And if you want more MechaBREAK content, please consider subscribing to the channel, as we'll be sharing some regular videos down the road. That's it for this video. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you in the next one.